Hey, could you get corn? Corn did word up.
Oh, I remember when they did that.
Did you like corn, Sam?
I like the first two albums.
Yeah.
We knew corn before.
Oh, when they were still on the cob.
There you go. There you go.
Oof.
Your vocal cords should be confiscated.
This band's got to be close to 20 years old now, too.
Oh, definitely.
Korn. Holy fuck, because we played Korn at AF.
They're classic rock now.
That would be considered classic rock. Crazy. If you had a true classic rock station, you would have to play Korn.
We had a man.
Look at what he looks like. He's like got to say queen. Something.
Come on.
They did kind of, and everyone's laughing on TV. Laughing. This is if the thing doesn't go away, you got to say something.
Yeah.
So Bruce, you got to say something. Everyone's laughing at you now.
We had Korn at K-Rock.
Yes, we did.
They did the walkover with us.
They were very cool.
All right.
We liked those guys a lot.
I think by the time this song came out, they were not that cool anymore.
Well, when you start dipping into doing covers,
yeah,
that's just the kind of
I am. But the first two albums,
an attempt to keep your popularity up.
They were fucking awesome for the first two albums.
Let me hear a little of this, though. They did a great job at this, though.
Yeah.
This is a cover.
Thank you, Chris.
Why did he superimpose his face on wild dogs?
That's pretty cool. It looks like fucking the thing, the John Carpenter version.
Yeah.
But it kind of looks like Tim Tebow as a dog. Anyone else see that?
Tim Tebow.
I think this was their way of competing with rock rap when the Limp Bizkit got popular.
Yeah.
What year is that?
It's all right.
Probably like the late
90s.
It's not bad for that song as a cover for that dumb song.
It's like, it feels like somebody competing with Limp Bizkit.
Faith
is better.
And Faith? Limp Bizkit was great when Limp Bizkit put that out.
People make fun of Limp Bizkit, but that version of Faith is ridiculous.
What was that? That was when they were cool.
Let's hear it.
You've never heard Limp Bizkit do Faith?
I may have and just don't recognize
that one. Yeah, you won't like it.
Holy fuck. Yeah. Was it Wham or was it George Michael's on his own Faith?
George Michael.
George Michael's song.
Yeah, this was post Bush's.
Fucking thing.
And if Fred Durst weren't such a douche, it'd be like this would still hold up.
Right.
But it's hard to.
Yeah, they just
get
don't
away
like Fred
that.
Durst as a person.
Well, you think he's hardcore? If I could touch your body, I know not everybody has got a body like me. But I gotta think twice before I give my heart away. And I know all the games you play, cause I play them too.
Here we go. Strap in, kids.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it gets really heavy.
Like, ridiculously heavy.
Oh, here he goes. Well, it takes a song, man, baby, but I'm showing you that door. Run, gotta have faith. Oh, man. Look at the audience just going, bullshit. Fred Durst.
Look at that crowd, though. Fuck.
It's good.
How did Fred Durst turn into such a douche so fast?
Because he was fucking awesome when this song came out.
What happened? Yeah, why is it perceptive, this guy, that he's a douche?
People loved Fred Durst.
He got too big, too fast. And he came out with Nookie, So You Could Take a Cookie. And that song got so big and just destroyed him.
Nookie, So You Can Nook a Cookie? What the fuck does that mean?
Stick it up your hay.
Stick it up your hay.
Stick it up your hay. Yeah. Stick it up your hay.
He was there for one of our benchmark bits, too.
What bit?
The turkey bit, eh?
Oh, right. Yeah.
He was in the rock bus when we were getting fucking attacked.
Oh. Oh, man.
huh?
Is he still considered cool?
Not even a little bit.
No?
He's one of the least cool people. He's on Billy Ray Cyrus level.
Well, they did that song together on...
I know.
Is he still trying to do it?
He pops up every now and then.
He's on our studio recently with Billy Ray Cyrus.
Man, the 90s had a sound.
It's like the end of the 90s.
Yeah,
end of the 2000s.
Yeah, this is really the end of the 90s right here.
Jesus. That's pretty fucking cool.
Yeah. Oh, boy. That was the 90s right. Were a pisser, weren't they?
That was that turkey thing we should talk about.
Turkey
for a
foot?
We're
just playing turkey.
We come up with this bit to just fuck over the entire audience. I'm surprised Dave Douglas allowed us to do it.
No, guys.
And we found a field. We promoted, like, for a while that for Thanksgiving you could catch your own turkey. And and PETA was all over us, remember?
Yeah.
PETA was always all over us.
She was saying, bring whatever weapons you want.
Right. So we're like, look, you can't bring guns, but you can bring anything else you want to catch these, you know, turkeys for Thanksgiving. The key is we never said live turkeys, but we just kept saying, and people would call. Remember, we would just take call after call. Could I bring a net? Yeah, man. Baseball bat? Yep.
Sure.
Yep, that's
put
on the
spike
list.
Through it.
Right. All sorts of fucking things. And then people were calling up with creative, like, things they were building to catch their turkeys and stuff. It really was a huge bit for us at the time.
Mm-hmm.
So then we pulled the rock bus into this open field. I'm trying to remember where. Somewhere in, like, Framingham area, I guess. And
did they show up with weapons and bats and stuff?
Dude, I swear they did. Yeah. And I would love, if anyone out there, any of the old-timers have pictures of that event, I would love to see them, and I would love to hear the broadcast. I don't
even
know
if pictures back then.
I know they didn't take as many pictures, and I would love to hear the broadcast. I don't even know if the broadcast holds up. But then Fred Durst was there. We had to do an interview with Fred Durst, like in just before it or in the middle of it or something like that. Anyway, long story short, we lined everybody up with their homemade weapons and all sorts of crazy shit. They had lacrosse sticks, if you remember, and hockey sticks.
A lot of weaponry,
and we encouraged them to bring the weapons when we realized these guys were really into it. Anyway, so we sent them out in the field, and they're like, where are the turkeys? And we're like, they're way the fuck out there. They're kind of hiding. They're scared, you know? So they went running out, and long story short, we placed paper turkeys in the fields and behind bushes and rocks and behind trees and whatnot.
And you could exchange it for a frozen turkey.
Was the bit in the end.
Yeah.
But we didn't feel like telling them any of that shit.
You guys loved to trick people in those
days.
Yeah.
Oh, a lot
I still
of
love
trickery
you
going
a
on. A lot
of tricksters.
I still
trickery.
Love it. It's just a lot harder to do these days. People are a little more savvy. So then I'll never forget. I remember like the first realization by these listeners that they were kind of had, but they weren't because they were still getting shit for it. And they found the paper turkey. And then the guy lifts it up like, what the fuck? And had the realization like, we just fucked them.
Yeah, because they didn't get to kill something.
And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, they all start running back toward the rock bus. And they fucking did, how much damage,
like
do you
zombies.
Remember? It was real shit.
Yeah, they started using their weapons, hitting it.
Hitting the rock bus. Rocking they were throwing it. Rocks at it. And I think there was snow on the ground at the time. Snowballs, rocks, fucking their weapons. Then they start shaking the thing. They were fucking pissed.
They just had all their turkey-killing aggression that they had to get out on somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
They were going to cave in some turkey skulls.
And then were there,
and we took that away from them.
And then we're there like with a bullhorn. No. The paper turkeys. You get a real turkey. And I think we threw in some other stuff. I don't remember exactly. But
they didn't care.
They didn't give a fuck. And
they,
I remember we
wanted to kill.
And they were breaking the windows of the rock bus. So I remember at one point we were actually under the broadcast table until we could figure out our bearings. Like, how bad is this going to get? And then we realized we were sort of okay.
Were you scared?
Slightly, I guess. I need the real answer. Slightly.
I didn't think they'd kill us.
I didn't. Yeah, but I
think they were just vandalizing.
Yeah, but I wasn't sure if I was going to get a rock to the head through the window or something at first.
Shards of glass being pelted your way.
Yeah.
But anyway, Fred Durst was there for that big, you know, benchmark event.
What year was that?
And he turned into a dick.
90.
I don't know how that happened to Fred Durst.
I'd guess 96, 97-ish. 97, probably.
So that Christina Aguilera thing?
Maybe it was the Christina Aguilera. I think,
Britney?
It was.
What did he do with her?
Two things. It was Eminem making fun of him.
Yeah, because Eminem had all the cred.
Right.
Right.
And he would only make fun of boy banders. So when he made fun of Fred Durst, it was like, oh, and then he came out with the Nookie and the Cookie.
Well, how did that go? The Nookie and the Cookie?
And that song, that song was so huge.
But it was catchy as all hell.
Of course.
But it really fucked up his credibility.
It was like the song of the year.
And people wouldn't, you know, let him live it down.
It turned on him.
Why does that shit turn on people if they have a massive over-the-top hit?
I don't know, because everybody likes it at first, but I guess then they just get sick of it, and then they get resentful of it.
Burnt out. It gets burnt out.
Play a little bit.
I don't know. I'm sure.
Yeah, you know this if you
have this.
Oh, man. Here's the fucking videos. Chicks.
They were always cool to us. I don't have anything bad to say about Fred Durst, actually.
I've never met him.
We did a lot of things with them over like a 2-year period when we were up in Boston.
That asshole. With his West? Dumb black eyes.
What's his name? West Borland? Is that it?
Oh, wow. Very good. He tried to do his own thing, right?
Yeah.
Good luck with that.
I was a Limp Bizkit fan in the beginning. But I turned on him like everybody else.
Hey!
Oh, he's going to do it all for the...
All the chicks are like, yo, let me follow Fred Durst.
Yeah, chicks are hot.
But they're shitty girls, though. Notice that? They're just like... They're just okay.
But they were hotter at the time.
Oh, is that what's going on there, you think?
Cornball City.
You think so?
Yes!
You know, they get to the streets.
Oh, cornball fucking city.
Here it comes, Jim.
Stick it up your yeah. Stick it up your yeah.
It's no mind.
Why?
This is fucking... I'm cringing.
Jimmy, you just don't know good shit, yo.
Word.
Yeah.
No, but I do know shit.
Fuck yeah.
Hey.
This is the type of music Chip would make.
Hey.
Yeah.
The winter coat.
Yeah.
Why is he wearing a winter coat in summer?
I don't know. Some of the girls are wearing like baby tees and tank tops.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
I hate the dance they do, the jump dance.
Is that Queens? Is this done in Queens?
Looks it. Or Brooklyn or something, right?
Maybe Brooklyn.
No, that looks more like Queens. You're right.
That kind of looks like Queens.
The start of Queens, where it's sort of warehousey and then turns into kind of...
Scott Shannon not retiring, by the way.
I heard. Where's he going to be?
I don't know. They must have been falling out.
I have a feeling he's going to be right here at SiriusXM.
He might be right.
Satellite radio. We're back here. We're free.
That won't be uncomfortable.
Wow.
That won't be uncomfortable.
Are you kidding me? I'd live for that.
I can't wait.
Yes.
Long Island City was the film location.
Oh, well,
let's see if we get in a bad mouth.
What are you fucking doing? That's Queens.
We figured out. I said the beginning of Queens.
Yeah.
Long Island City.
I learned a lot from you. Nookie
it looks
and the
like
cookie.
Those warehouses where, what's his name, had that Sirius XM equipment warehouse thing. What was his name?
Yeah,
Ziggy.
Yes.
Ziggy.
Good old Ziggy.
Yeah, it looks exactly like that.
Does he still have one?
Ziggy was in Long Island City.
Yeah, that's exactly where that was.
Does he still have that stuff?
No, I think he sold all that off.
Why?
Because you don't.
He did it for the Nookie.
Right.
So you can take that cookie.
That's where young Hendry was selling the cigarettes in Goodfellas.
Oh.
Out of the back of the truck was that area right there. Yeah.
That's probably during this video.
Yeah.
We're going to buy some ciggies.
Hey.
Take that ciggy and stick it up, yo.
Yeah.
Hey, by the way, when are we getting the next issue of that fucking show?
Oh, man. Well, there's a new one Sunday.
Why do we have to wait?
We shouldn't have to wait.
Like, we're some average schnook.
What are we?
That's Roro. Yo, Roro.
Where's Roland?
Sick.
Roll. We are not on the mile.
Really?
Yes.
How about that hunk of shit gets us the next
episode?
I'm gonna do a fake sick, so.
Are you?
Yeah, everyone else does this. What the fuck don't I do a fake sick? Of course.
I'm fucking
Remember Mars?
Sick.
Remember Mars?
Who's Mars?
He was the
fake sick guy.
Who is
fake?
I don't know who you're talking
about. I hear
about.
He's coming back Monday, finally.
This little, I think he was Mexican.
I literally didn't notice he was gone.
Who did?
Oh, wow.
I don't think
he's gone for like a month. Yeah.
The guitar player left for another band, but that's why Limp Bizkit fell apart? Not that, really.
I mean,
the signs were already there, exactly. And West decided, you know what, maybe he saw the signs? I saw the signs.
Opened up his eyes, he saw the signs.
Then West came back, though.
They were playing that song in Wawa the other day.
Yeah.
When I was down in Philly, and I just started laughing at myself.
Yeah.
And the real version of that song is really bad, too.
What, really?
Yes.
It's worse.
You could hear the signs in the original, too.
Let me hear that. No way.
Or maybe my brain is just fucking poisoned now with that song.
I know. I can't. Every time I hear it,
I heard this, and I'm like, it's not much better than the version we have.
I have to sing it like she's saying it when I hear it.
Jimmy, you like this video?
I love her rendition of this.
Okay. See the
Who is that? Ace of Base.
Oh, this is the original. Okay.
Yes.
Oh man.
She has hair like Marky Post.
Yes.
Dumb fucking face moles.
She said, recognize me.
Here we go.
You hear it a little bit?
So
oh, her fucking hand movements are enraging.
I think I'm poisoned.
Yeah.
It's a catchy tune, though, isn't it?
It is, right?
Yes, it is.
Right. Let me hear the whisper.
She might have nailed this.
I got a request for our video people out there that are syncing up our shit lately, uh-huh. And they're doing a great job. Really, really a great job. There's a few of you out there. Could someone please take the I Swore the Sign Girl from our show and sync it up to the actual Ace of Base video?
That'd be great.
But you got to send it to me. That one I want on my fucking channel, please. But I'll give you a nice little plug. Because that would be hilarious to see it synced up to the actual video. No?
Saw the signs.
Yes.
All right. Someone do that for me, please.
Saw the signs.
The guy's skipping around going,
without understanding. Yeah. I saw the signs.
Yeah.
And it opened. All right. Now I got to hear it. You got any?
Who's got it? Travis
got it?
Trav. Hit it.
Start this over. See if you can sync it up for us, Sam.
I love this.
Oh, yeah. Let's try to sync it up ourselves. Just see what it would look like. Hold on.
Okay.
What, Travis, where's your start again?
At the beginning. I have the full song.
All right. You guys start at the same time.
One, two, three, and we'll do it.
All right. Ready? One, two.
Hold on.
I don't want to blow it. Three.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I think we're off. Yeah, off, right?
Yeah. You hardly recognize me. Wait, we could do this.
Yeah.
No. All right, how do we do this?
We're almost there.
Sure?
Just let...
You got it on pause where you are?
No, I'm going to start it over.
What? No.
What? I need some lyric.
Go to the first I Saw the Sign.
Okay.
Travis, please. Yeah. And then, Sam, you find the first I Saw the Signs. And then at least
is my computer off?
Yes, and then both kill yourselves.
Okay. All right, hold on. No, Travis, but stop it right before
that. No,
no,
you're right, but stop me, Sam. You gotta.
Sinking stuff is so fucking frustrating.
No, you're letting it go. Wait till right, boom. Perfect.
All right, wait. No.
No, you play. No, stop right there.
All right, there it is. It stopped at I.
At I. Okay. So who stopped at I?
I
did.
Travis.
All right. Now, are you stopped at the first I?
Hang on, you gotta go back.
Open her eyes, I saw the signs. without understanding. I so you opened up my eyes. No one's gonna drag
this is so
you
visual.
To get into yeah. the light where you belong.
It'll work though.
It's awful.
I just gotta hear us singing.
I got a new game. There's an evening I've wondered who you are. I'm your person like you, baby. Joy.
She
I'm
must hate this.
Where I see a lot of stars. Is it love in the eyes or the sun? Is it open up my eyes or the sun? Life's too mounting without understanding. I saw the sign. And it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong.
Breathy.
But where do you belong?
That's one of my favorite bits of audio ever.
It's the greatest thing that was ever put on tape from this program.
Somebody please sync this up for me. Send it to me. I got to put it on my YouTube channel.
So fucking fantastic.
Add some of the original Ace of Base song just to pump it up a bit.
I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. And I am happy not living without you.
Why is she going to do that?
I saw the sign. Opened up my eyes, I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong. Sign, I saw the sign, yeah. I saw the sign, oh, I saw the sign. I saw the sign, I saw the sign. I saw the sign, I saw the sign. And it opened up my eyes, I saw the sign, sign, sign.
Jesus Christ, I love it.
All right, someone do that good. For us. Thank you.
Oh, God.
Fuck. Footer wants to stick up for Fred Durst. We ran out of show, though. Oh,
come on.
Footer's a regular, though.
What Footer?
Yo, Foots. Footer, what up, buddy?
My nickname.
What up, boys? Yeah, I was getting a communique that you guys were bashing Durst. I think it's just like a cool thing to do to bash him. That's the problem. Because, I mean, think about where
really
it
scorch.
Is so wrong.
Yeah, first, I just heard that Cookie for the Nookie song. It's fucking bashable.
But it was a huge hit.
It was the biggest hit.
By a lot of things if you're in music to make hits, then he fucking accomplished
Absolutely.
It. I don't have anything bad to say about him, Footer. We did some cool stuff with him back in the day.
All I'm saying is he was cool, and then all of a sudden he just wasn't cool to the people anymore.
And we're trying to figure out why.
I'm not even talking about personally. Personally, I don't give a shit.
Right.
But like he just isn't.
No, yeah. he was immediately not cool.
It was such a fast, you're not cool anymore.
It was the fast, maybe the fastest ever.
Oh, yeah, because from being so cool.
Right.
Legitimately, in industry, as far as like behind the scenes, rolling around Hollywood and Jim, you're a fucking Hollywood Jim. You know, I mean, Durst is a fucking
Hollywood Jim.
He's a what?
Yeah. Durst is a player in Hollywood. He really is. I mean, he's not fucking, you know,
No one talks about him anymore.
No, he does.
I mean, I'm not.
No
look,
one
he's got,
is talking about
he's more famous than I am, but no one's talking about
him. He was on Arsenio with Billy Ray Cyrus.
Yeah. What
were they doing together?
They sang. We played the clip on the show.
Well, I don't remember.
It was really bad.
I really don't remember.
Do you want to see it?
No,
real quick?
We got to go home.
All right.
Yeah. All right, go home, boys.
All right.
Thanks, Footer.
Guys, guys in fucking love with Fred Durst over there.
I know. Fucking guy. What are they going to? Were they fucking get a hotel room at the Borgata together?
About, right? Oh, why would they want to do that, Jim?
Because Valentine's Day tomorrow.
Yeah.
And since they can't get tickets then early show Saturday, they may want to come to that late show.
Right.
And then make love after. Or if they're in Pittsburgh, February the 28th, I'm at the Carnegie Music Hall. Ontario, California has been added March 6th through 8th. Virginia Beach, Virginia is now March 20 through 22. Tampa, Florida is now April 11 and 12. I'm gearing up to shoot another special.
Nice.
So that's what I'm doing for these next, I guess, month and a half or so.
Ah.
Lately I feel like crash. I can't believe what's happening. They talk about money.
He hasn't aged, that's for sure. I really don't remember us playing this. Maybe I wasn't here.
Didn't get positive reviews on the show.
No.
Was it considered not a particularly good?
He looks good, though. He looks exactly the same.
Which isn't necessarily
don't forget our
something.
Oh, our podcast. Our latest one's another really good episode. The Opie and Anthony podcast. Go to iTunes so we get some bragging rights with the other podcasters. Basically, this week it's Ricky Gervais and Joe Rogan
meeting for the first time ever.
And doing a radio show together for the first time, and it was great. I mean, great radio. So please go get that and spread the word.
I saw the Science Girl doesn't want any part of the show anymore.
Zero.
Who
wouldn't want to relive the glory of Ice with the Swines?
I don't know. Her and Cream Pie Jones are off together somewhere happy.
Dude, I want to hear her sing that again more than anything.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I want a fucking, you know, like a reunion concert.
Yeah.
Well, I bet it wouldn't sound good, though. She'd be like, I saw that would be all different.
Right.
She nailed it that time.
She killed it. I remember going through emails for that karaoke contest and just, like, email after email of, like, this is, ugh. And then that email came through, and I was like, holy shit.
Gold, right?
She's the greatest.
People are complaining there might not be a clean copy out there, so could we just play it so they could grab it off the radio?
Yeah, you want to play it out?
Yeah, so they could sync it up with the video. All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow. We're going to play that thing one more time for the people that might want to sync it up for us. Thank you.
I saw it. What you see? I saw it. I'm all in the world. I got a new life. You would hardly recognize me. I'm so glad I'm a new person. Like you, really is you. I did bother when you're not the one for me. Is enough enough? I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. Life is demanding without understanding. I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong. But where do you belong? I got a new game. There's any years I wonder who you are. I'm a new person. Like you bring me joy. I'm in a pale moon where I see a lot of stars. Ooh, is enough enough? I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. Life's demanding without understanding. I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong. But where do you belong? And it opened up my eyes, and I am happy not living without you. I left you, I saw the sign. Opened up my eyes, I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong. Sign, I saw the sign. 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 And it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign.